Alright, cool. Strochenzo here. Today we're gonna ride.
Is that what you think I do?
Yeah.
You make it look so easy.
What's up guys, Chenzo here. So today I'm back out at Seguin Mountain Bike Skills Park. I was out here last month and I got a little cindy, sent some bigger jumps and did some gap jumps. But after looking at the video a few times, I did notice there's still some shortcomings in my form and in my technique. So that's what I'm gonna work on today. I'm gonna dial it back just a little bit and start working on my timing and my preload and my pump, and especially working on my landing. And I want to, kind of go into my jumps more confidently, land them more confidently, and then, you know, go right into the next jump and start kind of stitching them together. So that's the game plan for today. And yeah, let's do it.
So I started out today's ride on the step down jumps at the top of the hill. These jumps are quite a bit different from the ones that I usually hit at the bottom of the hill. Down there they tend to flatten out quite a bit and it's easier to visualize the landing. Up here the transitions are steeper and these are step downs, so you can't really see the landing until right before you jump.
See, I mean, it doesn't look bad from here. It definitely looks doable, but coming downhill is another story.
A blind landing makes these jumps just a little bit more difficult than what I'm used to. Fortunately, the homie Shane joined me on today's ride. You guys might remember Shane from my last Seguin ride when he helped me send it over this gully gap jump and gave me a ton of useful advice.
It helps you kind of recalibrate, grab it, okay.
He came out today to get cindy, but he also took some time to give me some pointers and to coach me through some of these jumps. While I'm sessioning these jumps, I want to thank everyone who's been following my jump progression and providing feedback and or critiques. If you're an experienced mountain biker, I hope you at least find this video entertaining. And if you're a new mountain biker like me, hopefully you find this video useful. I know there's a ton of how to jump tutorial videos out there from riders that are much better than myself, and I encourage you guys to watch all of them. But I like to think there's some value in documenting this process as I'm learning it, and showing you guys the good, the bad, and the frustrating parts of progression. So if you're new here, and you want to stick around for the adventure, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future progression videos like this one.
I want to clear this one here. So from here it doesn't look too bad, but the problem is the approach just gets in my head. And I'm always wondering if I have enough speed. So here it goes.
So I didn't rush the process at all today. I sessioned the first jump at least 7 or 8 times before attempting the second one. This process of slow progression was a theme of today's ride, and I promise I'll hit some bigger jumps later in the video, but I just want to emphasize that there's nothing wrong with hitting the same jump as many times as it takes until you feel comfortable.
I think you could hit it with more speed if that's the jump you're talking about.
It's almost like you're coming up, you know, a couple feet right before the end, so you're already coming up before you take off.
All right, cool, man. I think I can come into it with a little bit more confidence and speed.
Just a little speed and you got it.
After some feedback and advice from Shane and Audra, I made a few adjustments, and then I kept sending it.
Man, that felt good. Oh, we're warm, man. We're warm. Drop it!
I knew I was warmed up and things were finally starting to click, so I decided to step it up a notch and send this entire left jump line. On the way back up, I happened to stumble upon Chris Wood, the trail builder and mountain bike director at the Skills Park.
And like I said, if you're not really certain about that jump and you see someone hitting it, let them tow you in for that speed. So you guys be safe, know your limits, okay?
Yes, sir.
Don't want anybody getting hurt. Everything's pretty safe. It's all floater jumps, nothing's BMX-y.
Yeah.
Perfect. It's all about carrying that momentum.
He gave us a quick pep talk about sending this tree jump, and then he offered to tow us in. I couldn't pass up that opportunity, so I went for it. And it was so good, we hit it again.
shit, that felt so good. Woo, yeah. That was so good, man. Good stuff, woo, brother.
I didn't send the second one because I
missed it. Damn, that felt good. Send it.
And of course, we couldn't leave without revisiting that gully gap from last time. I made a conscious effort to time my pump a little better this time, and I also shifted my position on the bike to improve my landing. Compared to my last time hitting this jump, I would say my landing looks a lot cleaner, and my wheels match the transition much better than before.
Woo! Man, that felt good. Hell yeah, dude.
You all beat them all?
We all cleaned them, man.
Hell, you got it?
Hell yeah, brother.
Yeah.
Good stuff, my man. Damn. Well, thanks for towing us in, man. We appreciate it.
No problem. This is my third park I've built.
Okay.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I build, you know, I'm a contractor, but I build mountain bike parks and motocross tracks.
We caught up with Chris Wood afterwards to get some info about his jump classes. He was teaching some new bikers how to jump, and in a couple of hours, these guys were confidently clearing 8 to 10 foot gaps. So if you're new to jumping, I would definitely recommend you consider his class. I'll leave his info down below.
But I do 2-hour lessons. It's like $25 cash, and all that money goes to the children's center.
Oh, nice. Awesome, dude.
Okay. Yeah.
What was your name, and how did they get a hold of you?
I'm Chris Wood.
Chris Wood? Okay.
And I'm the mountain bike director and the park builder here.
Awesome.
At Seguin.
Okay.
Cool. Well, thank you.
Appreciate the info, man. Thanks a lot, brother.
You guys, just stay safe. Know your limits.
Yes, we'll do.
Totally.
Okay.
We'll
do.
Set out today. I made a few goals that were attainable, but a little bit scary. You know, these first two step down jumps are really, they're nothing to sneeze at. But all I really wanted to do today was work on my form, work on my technique. Stitch a few jumps together, start landing jumps consecutively, and just start building some confidence. I didn't know if I was gonna hit that tree jump, but you know, I was feeling really good, and I took it one jump at a time. Steady progression was pretty much the tone of today's ride. So I just wanna thank you guys for watching. As always, stay stoked, and I'll see you in the next one. Did you have fun, baby? Awesome.